hairy area, see the difference in the thickness. Very big and then very thin for perineurium. And then you have the nerve fibers. I say it looks like they have a little tutu around them. But yeah, the myelin isn't stained like it was in the other slide, where these are stained a dark brown color. And that's the more natural staining of the peripheral nerve. So you see all the little dots, and that's a peripheral nerve cross section. All the nerve fibers. Okay. So you can name a lot right here. I would start with, where is this from?
Ovary.
The organ structure is this from?
Ovary.
Ovary. So this is ovarian, see that right away. Okay, well, what's the layer up here called? There's the TA, tunica albuginea. And then these cells right underneath it?
Primordial.
Primordials, right there. If I say, well, some of them are starting to show cells just around the exterior. Makes them
primary.
They're getting organized. And then this is the best example.
Secondary.
And I say, well, you're starting to get some fluid right here. What are you going to call it?
Secondary.
Just starting to get some fluid on the one side, the beginnings of an antrum. I would be descriptive and say, this is starting to accumulate right there. All extra bodies, beginnings of the antrum. That always tells you it's now secondary. Just a little bit of space filled with that liquor folliculi. All right, very good. This is the biggest challenge of the night. High magnification of a neurological tissue. Can you tell where it's from?
Cerebellum.
What you have to see is this layer. Four beads. Put this together and say, this is from?
Cerebellum.
Cerebellum, all the way. Why?
Granular.
Granular, always. Or?
Purkinje
cells. The sulcus is up here. What's this tissue?
Pia.
Pia. A little bit of pia in the sulcus. Now you have gray with three layers. The real tip-off is the granular. And then here?
Granular.
Always on the interior?
Okay.
White. So this is the white matter, or arbor vitae with cerebellum. The only difference with cerebellum, you've got three layers, with cerebrum, six. The thing is, you don't have that distinctive granular layer for cerebrum. Gray layers. If you saw that, yeah, you're ready to go for neuroisco. Granular layer, I'm always telling you cerebellum. Well, this was just a show off. That's hundreds of hours to do this. Spinal cord dissection, incredibly delicate. And yet you're showing off when you actually keep part of the meninges. This part?
Sure.
What are you going to call it? 10? Most of it's been removed, but they just kept a little segment of it. That's the dura. Dense, very tough outer coat. But then we go to the interior. I said, well, go down to this point right here where it changes. So what are you gonna call this point at 12? That's where it shifts to the appearance. And I would always have a better, more enlarged specimen. Conus. And this is the conus of the cord. And then all these descending roots. 13. Cauda. Yeah. So you go conus to cauda. Business, you only need to use the first word. So the cone and now the tail. I brag that, yeah, my lab students could tell the difference. Conus, product. And I said, I would always have a more enlarged specimen for that identification. Alright, okay. And this is your. Your last larson. And challenge you. Where's the humor? Graduate exam. You take mine, I take yours. Right? So he was looking at it, kicking off a little bit. Suiting yourselves prep for a great performance. Thank you guys for all tonight.